Hi, this is Gaylord, and I thought I'd show you how to do Sweet Home Alabama on an acoustic guitar. Now, this is a Taylor T5. It's a semi-hollow body electric. I've got an 816 Taylor that's in the shop. They're working on a fret, so hurry up, Taylor. Get that thing back to me. Anyway, the key to playing, when you're playing an acoustic guitar, you're normally playing by yourself, or you've got a guy like I do that, since I don't have the vocals, I've got a guy that sings behind me, and we do that, and I have a drum machine. But you want to be able to make that sound as full as possible. So anytime you get a chance that you're playing like that, you're playing licks, anytime you get a chance to hit a chord or any part of a chord, fill it in by hitting it, okay? And I'll show you what I'm talking about here in just a minute. So, Sweet Home Alabama, you want to start off with a D, and you're going to hit the open fourth string. It's like that, but you don't want to just set it let it ring out. So I use the palm of my hand to mute that fourth, like that, okay? And I'm also hitting the fourth and the third, just to give it a little bit more of a sound. And then it's the third fret on a second, and the second fret on a third. That's all it is, like that. Then you go down to a C chord, make a C chord, and you're hitting that fifth string again, and then you go to second, first fret, open third. And then you go down to a G and hit that sixth string, okay? Like that. Now there's a chance right there to hit that full chord. So when you hit that, when you get down to your G, you want to make it that sound full chord. And what I do is I'm picking up on it. I'm strumming that whole chord up straight. So. Now the first time I do something like this, and I change these riffs up and these licks up every time I play it. And this may not be the same way as they do it on the record, but when you're playing by yourself, you just want to throw some riffs in there and make it sound full. So. That's the first thing you can do. And all you're doing there is a walk on the second frets on the third, fourth, and fifth string. Okay. Do a riff on that. I'm going to change it up a little bit, and I'm going to do a riff on that G. And all I'm doing there is holding the second and third string, or first string down on the third fret. Okay, and do a slide from the on the third string, fourth fret down to the second fret, and then. In there in the beginning. Now the only other thing I'll show you here real quick is that other lead riff in the middle where he goes. And all you're doing there is I'm doing a slide on my index finger. I'm going to start on my index and do a slide up to the seventh, and then with my ring finger I'm going to hit that ninth fret on the fifth string. 7th fret on the 4th, and then the 4th and 3rd strings combined, so. And then you're doing that same, pretty much the same riff, but you're going down starting on the 5th fret. Okay, see what I'm doing there? Go down to the riff on the fifth, and then I'm doing starting. Oh. open fifth, and I'm doing this on the fifth and the fourth string. And that's that, like I'm hitting a G, and I'm going to hit a G there. And then I like to do a little riff in there that's just anything that's going to fill it up, okay? There you go. I hope that helps you a little bit. If you have any trouble with it, let me know. This is Gaylord. See you later. Bye-bye.